So for you Christians who think that it's taboo to talk about sex in the church, just hear me out before you close me out, okay? So this morning, I was struggling to not masturbate. Awkward for me to share, yes, but this is why I'm saying it's important for me to share, because God showed me something. So I decided to open up my devotional, and lo and behold, it was about temptation, because you know the Lord is good and that's what he does. And basically it was saying to recite 1 Corinthians 10:13 in those moments of temptation, and that reads, "The temptations in your life are no different from what others experience, and God is faithful. He will not allow the temptation to be more than you can stand. When you are tempted, he will show you a way out so that you can endure." Okay, so every time I read a verse, I go before the verse, after the verse, and what is the context in which it was written to. So Paul was writing to the church, and he was using an example of how even Christians find themselves, falling into sin. And if you go to verse 8, it says, "And we must not engage in sexual immorality, as some of them did, causing 23,000 of them to die in one day." Lo and behold, what am I struggling with? Sexual immorality. Because God works like that. So then I go back down to verse 12, right before 13. And it says, "If you think you are strong enough, be careful not to fall." So he is giving a warning to Christians. Like, even we deal with these things. We have to be careful what we engage in, because our warfare is spiritual warfare. So then when you go to verse 13, and it says the temptations in your life are no different from what others experience, that's when I knew I had to share. Because I know I'm not the only one who struggles with masturbating, with any kind of sexual immorality. These words cannot be taboo in the church, because this is real. This is what we struggle with on a daily basis, our sins. And if we say that these things are awkward in the church, knowing that there's people out there struggling with it, the Lord says for us to confess our sins to one another, because there is power in the prayer of a righteous man. We're supposed to pray for our brothers and sisters. So then when we go down and he says that he will give us a way out, I knew that the reason that they shared 1 Corinthians 10:13 was because that is why it's important we have scripture encrypted on our heart. So when we find ourselves in those moments of temptation, we are able to use the word of God to combat that. We need to stay encouraged and stop saying that these words are taboo in the church, when we know that this is what we struggle with, against flesh and blood, but of principality.